Hello everyone, so in this module we'll be discussing about the structure of DNA. So as you know, DNA is composed of 4-deoxyribonucleotide. So this 4-deoxyribonucleotide are, one is deoxyadenylate, second is deoxyguanylate, third is deoxycytidylate, and fourth is thymidylate. Now, while writing the thymidylate, I'm not using word deoxy because thymine is only present in DNA and not RNA. But in case of adenine, guanine, and cytosine, they are also the component of RNA. So we have to specify that this is deoxy type of nucleotide, right? So deoxyribonucleotide, there are four in the structure of DNA, that is deoxyadenylate, deoxyguanylate, deoxycytidylate, and thymidylate. Now these nucleotides together are joined by a bond that is known as phosphodiester bond. So if I tell you the structure of nucleotide. So nucleotide is made up of sugar, base, and phosphoric acid. So this one nucleotide, it has a sugar, a base, and a phosphoric acid. So this various nucleotides together are joined by phosphodiester bond. This is present in the structure of DNA, that is nucleotide and the types of nucleotide. Now we'll see the polarity of DNA. Now if we talk of polarity of DNA, in case of DNA, the base sequences are written from 5 prime end to 3 prime end, and this is known as polarity of DNA. So polarity of DNA is 5 prime to 3 prime, okay? So there are upcoming batches on an Academy NEET PG where you can access free live classes. There are also topic-wise free PDFs of the classes, and there are free grant tests for NEET PG 2021 and free test series, that is T20. You can learn this all from top educators of India, and you have the access to unlimited courses, and you can just complete your syllabus in no time with doubt clearing sessions, with a lot of free study material and test and discussion. So under the mentorship of Unacademy, enroll now. Now as we're discussing the structure of DNA, we will be discussing the most important and the very common structure, that is Watson and Crick model. So what does this Watson and Crick model say? So there are some basic points that I'll be dealing. We'll be discussing in this lecture about 4 to 5 features. So let's move on. So feature number one, that is right-handed double helix. So in Watson and Crick model, number one that we have to see is right-handed double helix. So the DNA consists of 2-polydeoxyribonucleotide chain. So there are 2-polydeoxyribonucleotide chain, and both the chains are twisted around one another in the form of a double helix, or you can say right-handed double helix. So it gives an appearance like a spiral staircase. So you have to remember these 2 points in this first point about the Watson and Crick model. Number two that we have to see is the base pairing rule. When we talk of base pairing rule, you know that the 2 DNA strands are complementary to each other. So these are 2 strands,
and they're complementary to each other. That means if here it is adenine, it pairs with thymine. If here it is guanine, it pairs with cytosine. So the base pairing rule says adenine pairs with thymine and guanine pairs with cytosine. There's another rule that we have to remember in this point, that is Chargaff's rule. The Chargaff's rule say that in a structure of DNA, purine always equals to pyrimidine. So purine is ANG. And pyrimidine is CNT. Okay. So cytosine and thymine are always equal to adenine and guanine. Number 3, hydrogen bond. So as you know that adenine pairs with thymine with 2 hydrogen bond and cytosine pairs with guanine with 3 hydrogen bond. So this is the hydrogen bond. Now this hydrogen bond helps to stabilize the DNA and the strand to hold together. So here if I said this two are complementary, A pairs with T, G pairs with C, this pairs by 2 hydrogen bond and this pairs by 3 hydrogen bond. So the GC bond is stronger than AT bond because here there are 3 hydrogen bond and here there are 2 hydrogen bond. So this is about the hydrogen bonding. Now coming on to antiparallel. Number 4, antiparallel. So the two strands are antiparallel, run antiparallel to each other in a DNA molecule, which means two strands are antiparallel. That means if one runs from 5 prime to 3 prime, this runs from 3 prime to 5 prime. So if one strand is 5 prime to 3 prime, the other is 3 prime to 5 prime. It simply means that. This is similar to a road that is divided into two, each half carrying traffic in opposite direction. So now, suppose this is the road. It is divided into two. If this traffic is moving this side, then this traffic would be moving this side. So this is how it means to say anti-parallel. There are also some other features that we'll discuss. Suppose this is the DNA molecule. This is the DNA strand. Okay, so this hole is considered as one turn. In each turn, there are 10 base pairs. Okay, and 10 base pairs has about distance of 34 angstrom per turn. So one base pair has how much distance? So that comes to 3.4 angstrom, right? So the adjacent bases are separated by 3.4 angstrom. The whole distance is 34 angstrom. There are 10 base pairs in one turn, okay? And the diameter is 20 angstrom. So these are some of the features of and the structure of DNA.